This is part 5 of Parabolas. In this video, we cover how to graph functions in the form f of x equals ax squared, and we graph the following 5 parabolas. Okay, we are going to begin by graphing 3 functions on the same set of axes here. F of x equals x squared, which we've done on previous videos, and I've got that one here for you. That's like your y equals x squared, your basic parabola. And then also f of x equals 1 half x squared and f of x equals negative 2 x squared. So I've done a little chart here for if you have our normal 7 values for x, and I've written what x squared is. What I want you to do is fill out what 1 half x squared is and what negative 2 x squared is and plot the points for 1 half x squared that you can on this graph and plot the points for negative 2 x squared on this graph. So you should get 2 more parabolas. So put the video on pause and try that. All right, 1 half x squared, well that'll be half of whatever x squared is. So half of 9 is 4 and a half. Half of 4 is 2. Half of 1 is 1 half. Half of 0 is 0. Half of 1 is 1 half. Half of 4 is 2. And half of 9 is 4 and a half. So if we're going to graph y equals 1 half x squared, or f of x equals 1 half x squared, we're going to put in those numbers. Now the vertex is still here at 0, 0, but I go over 1 and up 1 half. So you know what? It's lower right here. And then I'm going over 2 and up 2. That's going to be right here. And then I'm going to go over 3 and up 4 and a half. So over 3 and up 4 and a half. And notice I'm putting corresponding ones on the other side, because the axis of symmetry for all of these is the y-axis, x equals 0. So that is our axis of symmetry for all of these. And our vertex for all of these is also going to be 0, 0. All right, so if I do this one graph, let's do one more. What if I put in 4 for x? X squared would be 16, half of that would be 8. So if I put in 4, 16, half of that would be 8. So for my graph here, if I go over 4, I go up 8. So if you want to see one more order pair, a couple more order pairs. So what I get is this graph right here. It's a little bit wider. And what's happening is all the y values here are half of what the y values are for the green. So up here it's at 9, right, at this point, where x is 3. There's an order pair up here where y is 9. Here it's only at 4 and a half. Okay, if we go over 2, up 4 for the average parabola, we're only going up 2. So we have a wider parabola for this y equals 1 half x squared. All right, now how about negative 2 x squared? Well, if we do that, I'm going to have to multiply the x squared by negative 2. So that'll be a negative 18, right? 9 times negative 2, 4 times negative 2 is negative 8. 1 times negative 2 is negative 2. Negative 2 times 0 is 0. And then I get these same order pairs here. All right, well, negative 3, negative 18. I'm not going to be able to put that on this graph. How about negative 2, negative 8? All right, so go negative 2 and down 8. Okay. Negative 1, negative 2. 0, 0. And then I have these corresponding ones on the other side. So what happens is this is a steeper parabola. That's because of this coefficient of negative 2. And also because it's negative, it ends up going down. So what we're doing is seeing what happens if we're looking at a function where we have ax squared. I've got two different a's here. The first one is just 1x squared, right? And that's our nice average looking parabola, the green one I have. And then we have f of x equals 1 half x squared. It's still going up because it's positive in front of the x squared, but it's wider, okay? everything's half as high, right? The y values are half as high. And for y equals negative 2x squared down here, it's a steeper graph because negative 2 is, if you look at the absolute value of negative 2, think of it that way, 2, it's going to be twice as big as 1, but it's going to be going down, upside down. So let's summarize this. All right, so to graph a parabola of the form f of x equals ax squared, we just did something like that. If a, this coefficient, is greater than 0, it opens up, and if a is less than 0, it opens down. If the absolute value of a is greater than 1, like 2 or negative 2 or 3 or negative 3 or 3 halves, etc., it ends up being a steeper graph. And if it's less than 1, like a fraction less than 1, like 1/3 or negative 1/3 or 1/2 or negative 1/2, it ends up being a wider parabola. And the vertex for all of these is 0, 0, and the axis of symmetry is still the y-axis. Whoops, I put x equals 1. It's the vertical line x equals 0. Sorry, it's the y-axis. So this is the equation of the axis of symmetry. The axis of symmetry is a line. So let's try another one. All right, so graph f of x equals negative 2/3 x squared. You want to get out graph paper, and you can either just plug in any values you want for x and get enough points to draw it, or you can think about what we just talked about to get an idea of what's going to happen. All right, so here's how I do it. I know 0, 0 is the vertex point, and also happens to be the x-intercept and y-intercept, right? And because it's negative, it's going to be going down. So I draw a little picture. I know it's going to be vertex 0, 0, and I know it's going to go down, and I know it's going to be kind of wide, wider, okay? Because of this 2/3, the absolute value of negative 2/3 is less than 1. So normally I would go over 1 and down 1, but I'm going to just do 2/3 of that. So I'm going to go over 1 and down 2/3. Right, remember we if we remember our basic numbers here, then you could just multiply by the 2/3 to decide how many places you go down, or you multiply negative 2/3 to get that actual ordered pair. So if I go over 2, instead of going down 4, I'm going to go 2/3 of 4. All right, so what's 2/3 of 4? Well, if you don't know, just write 2/3 times 4. That's 8/3, which is 2 and 2/3. Okay, so that means I'm going to go over 2 and down 2 and 2/3. And then if I go over 3 and down 9, all right, well, I'm going to go 2/3 of 9. Again, if you don't know what 2/3 of 9 is, then write it like that. And then 3 goes to 9 3 times, that's going to be 6. So we're going to go over 3 and down 6. So you could have just done your own chart, x and then negative 2/3 x squared, or you could have done it this way I'm doing it. And that's our parabola. Y equals negative 2/3 x squared. Now remember, f of x equals negative 2/3 x squared, y equals negative 2/3 x squared. Both of those are fine. You're just writing them in different ways. One's writing as a function, one's writing, with x's and y's. Here's one more for you to try. Graph f of x equals 1/4 x squared. So get out graph paper, put the video on pause, and try that on your own. All right, so this time everything is just the y values are 1/4 of the y values for just y equals x squared. So we have 0, 0, and instead of 1, 1, it's going to be 1, 1/4. It's still going to go up, right? We're going to have 0, 0, but it's going to be going up. And it's going to be pretty wide because of that 1/4. All right, so over 2, I would normally go up 4. I'm going to go a fourth of 4. That means only going up one space. So when I say you could make a chart, you could do x and 1/4 x squared. You could put in your values here, positive or negative, really, because they're going to have mirror images. So this would be 1/4 of 9. Sorry, that 1/4 of 9. Sorry. So 9 versus 2 and a fourth. So over 3, I'm just going 2 and a fourth. And then there's going to be one over here on the other side. And you could try 4, for instance. If you do 4, you're going to do 1 fourth of 16, right? Which is over 4 and up 4. So you get the idea. This is going to be a much wider graph. And that's how yours should have looked. And you're ready for some more problems on the next video. We're going to add on.